guys, Acolyte Lake here, and I'm here to talk to you about my new Battlegrounds best friend, which is HSreplay's Battlegrounds extension that they are calling Tier 7. They just announced it today on their Twitter, and the site is now live for everybody to use. What's really, really cool is they made their tier list accessible for free. You do not have to pay for Tier 7 in order to get access to their tier lists. So, props to them for making that feature free. I think that's pretty amazing. What's included in Tier 7? Well, that will show you some really cool features, like which compositions are best for which heroes and when to tavern up. Now, if you've played a lot of Battlegrounds, you'll know that choosing to tavern up at the right times, especially in the new Dragon meta with such minions in Tier 5 and Tier 6 being really important to the game, it's important to tier up at the right times with different heroes, and all that data is available to you in their Tier 7, which is $4.99 a month, and I think it's worth it. I'm gonna show it to you so you can get a look at it right now for free and talk to you about the features, especially talk to you about compositions and how to pick the best compositions for your hero. Okay, so let's start here. When you first log in to hsreplay.net/battlegrounds, you will get access to this tier list for free. The first thing you're going to want to do is click on MMR range and choose which one you're in, whether you are in the top 50% or top 20%. Right now I have it chosen for the top 20%, and it does change. So you can see the heroes chosen at different MMRs really is different. So make sure to change this, and this is what you'll see. There's a whole list and they are separated by tier. Now, in this tier, you'll see their average placement. So, on average, if you choose Deathwing, you'll get somewhere between 3rd and 4th place. And then, on average, for example, if you choose Edwin, you'll get 4th place, most of the time. Now, depending on how good you are with a hero, could change this. So, you can see all of the heroes and their stats. And one thing I really like is on the side over here, it'll tell you what percentage of people, which percentage of players will hit first, second, and third. I'm going to show you some stats on a lower ranked hero. We'll go down to not winning, or they actually call this losing up here in the corner. We'll take Maleficent Mana Storm, which this might change because she recently had a buff. On average, players get about fifth place, but if you take a look at this on the stats, more people get above fifth place than get above fourth place. So you're more likely to get fifth, sixth, seventh, or eighth place if you choose this hero. So in general, a terrible hero to choose, again, pending if the statistics change because this hero just had a nerf. Now, what you cannot choose, what you cannot get with the free access is looking deeper into the hero at which comps perform best. It will show you which comp will perform best, but that could be by a marginal difference, and it won't show you the best comp for the hero. So let's click on Deathwing. And Deathwing's a hero I talk about a lot on stream because a lot of people just immediately go towards Beast, but you'll see that there's not a huge difference between that and Deathrattle Mech. So this is the data that you'll get access to if you choose Tier 7. And Tier 7 is $4.99 a month. I think it's super worth it. 74%, well, almost 75% of people choose Deathwing. And here's the placement distribution. Also coming down here, you'll see when to tier up. Now this changes with different heroes. Different heroes should tier up on different taverns earlier or later, depending, you know, on their hero power. For example, Yogg, often you'll skip tiering up on 2. It just depends on if you got a token generating minion or not. So there's definitely different reasons. So Beast composition in this one is 31% popular, but then mechs are 25% popular. However, if you look at hero affinity, which is the difference in average final placement, 1st through 8th, between players who play the composition with this hero and players who play a different composition with this hero. So the difference in placement is half a placement. So, and then the difference with mechs is 0.02 difference of a placement between these ones. So mechs and beasts are only separated by a half point, which is the difference between getting 3rd and a half place or 4th place, which if you've ever paid attention when you win a game, you're always awarded with like a placement, third, fourth, fifth, or sixth, but sometimes your points are awarded based on third and a half place, or if a bunch of you tied for a particular place, for example. So not a giant difference between beasts and mechs. I find that the higher I got up in MMR, the more I found Divine Shield mechs work better, but the stats are saying something different here, so the stats really are pretty cool. Next up, we're going to talk about composition. I think that this is a really important feature, and I'm a big fan. Let's say you chose the hero Deathwing, and you see that the most winning composition is beasts. If you look over to the side, it will show you a typical final board and the best composition to finish with if you want to get first place. Now, if you're like me, I have a lot of top four finishes, but my percentage of first place finishes to top four finishes is kind of low, and I would like to improve that. So data like this will help a player like me finally go from a top four to a first place, just by trying to get the best board possible. If you scroll up to the top of HSreplay.net and you are a Tier 7 member, you'll see that there's another section for compositions. So if you click under compositions, you get even more data, and you can click on the composition individually to find out exactly how it works and what's popular and when to tier up based on this composition. So not only are there particular times to tier up for your hero in general, but different times to tier up based on which composition you choose if you want to get the minions to fit that composition. For example, if your composition depends on having a Hydra and you stay at tier 3 for too long, your odds of getting an important component to your build decreases. So you want to make sure to pay attention to when you decide to tier up to have the best possible chances of building the perfect comp. Another cool feature under the composition tab is the popularity of all minions in the composition over the course of the game. So you can find out the comparison between all the different minions and their lasting ability throughout the game. For example, Alley Cat here, as you could predict, is very popular in the beginning of the game, and by the end of the game is completely phased out. Whereas, of course, other minions you can't even get until, you know, turn 4, 5, or 6, and they tend to last throughout the game. If we look at the curve here on Goldrin, people just don't throw him out, so they keep him on the board. Very important to know which minions are worth holding onto and which minions are worth tossing back to Bob. Finally, there is a section where you can get some HSreplay fame. So if you look over here, perfect beast game examples. A perfect game with beasts is a game where the player has not lost a single round of combat and consistently played beasts from turn 7 onward. Win a perfect game under these conditions at a higher MMR with Hearthstone Deck Tracker to get included on this list. This list may take several hours to update, so you can see a couple people here have already made the list by having a perfect beast game. So a little bit of fame here if you're someone who likes to make leaderboards and likes to make lists. And then down here, you can compare different minions at the different tiers, which is pretty cool. Let's take a look at tier 2, which I think is very important in the early game to choose minions correctly. We can go to compare minions here. And it takes us back up to the top, and we can compare the three minions that were in that tier and how important they are, how effective they are, and their lasting ability throughout the game. So a lot of information on this new extension for HSreplay. I've been loving it. Like I said earlier, I got to playtest this for a week. It's really helped my game. I grew, I was lower 6,000. Well, here's what happened. I hit 7,400, which was my highest MMR, and then dropped way down to about 6,000. So I lost 1,400 MMR points in a single week, just a bad week. We've all had those. And after I got this extension and got to test it out, I improved my MMR even higher than when I started. So I grew, I think I hit 7,600. So I grew 1,600 MMR points just by using this feature, and I think it was super helpful. So let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. I'm happy to answer any questions you have as best as I can, or I can refer you to someone who can answer them for you. And as always, if you like content like this, please hit like and subscribe, and continue supporting the channel. Thanks, you guys.